After the absolutely intense battling that went on between Galbadia and Balam Gardens, we are now in the basketball court of Balam Garden, and now we are in the rather extravagant entranceway, foyer, lobby. I'm not sure what this is, but the chandeliers are nice. Welcome back to Final Fantasy VIII. We are fast approaching some heavily indicative moments of the end of the disc, but who knows if it'll actually be the end. So this, if I remember correctly, will lead us into the large open area. Yeah, this is where we met Raijin and Fujin on disc one. When they were looking for Cypher. Perfect. This is exactly what I wanted. That very, very, very scary creature. I'm not sure how well this is going to go over. But considering the fact that Squall deals thousands of damage, I think we'll be alright for the fight, but he probably has high defense. No dialogue, just straight into the battling against this thing. This, my friend, is Cerberus, and he's an extremely useful guardian force. Do people here know GF? Ah, let's just take it pretty confident. Let's see how you do. Hopefully pretty well. 3,000 damage. This will be over in a second. Renoa's doing good damage too. Let's see how good Zell does. 900 from a crit. It's looking like I won't need to, limit break. Show me what you got. Cerberus is a very, very confident guardian force. For someone that does no damage, I should probably check what he has to draw just to be safe. Not bad, mortals. Did I beat him? Triple is a ridiculous spell to junction. I cannot believe. So Cerberus's card, I remember a really neat trick with Cerberus's card. It card mods into 100 lightweight items. And I can't exactly reap the benefits of that now, but if I hang on to those 100 lightweight items and I get a guardian force that we're not going to get immediately but a little bit into the future, I can turn that into an item that teaches a guardian force auto-haste, and Cerberus learns auto-haste by default, meaning that just from defeating Cerberus, I'm going to be able to get two characters that always start every battle with haste, so their ATB gauge goes up very fast, and it's super exciting. I can't wait for that. Okay, Quetzalcoatl and Carbuncle learned some new things. Cerberus has got a pretty neat icon. Let's take a look at him. Right after Pandemona, so we know we're not missing any. Strength junction by default, magic, spirit, and speed junction together, and he can junction hit by default, which means normally he would be terrible on Squall because Squall already has max hit, but we're going to keep him on Squall and move Pandemona down to Cell. No, let's do Renoa, actually. And his signature ability that he learns prevents being back attacked, which is, to me personally, incredibly useless. So I should say that he doesn't have auto haste by default, but actually he has ability times 3, that's why we're putting him on Squall, so he can, Squall can have a ton of strength plus on him. But eventually he will learn, I'm not sure what the trigger is, but eventually Cerberus will learn auto haste and it will be great. Let's go ahead and actually use Quetzalcoatl's card mod on that. 100 lightweights. There we go. And let's hang on to those because we need 100 of them, so I can't even lose one of them. Alright, let's take Pandemona off of Squall, give him Cerberus, and then. Okay, so as soon as Ifrit learns whatever he was learning. bad. I don't want Ultima to go on to hit. So I'm gonna actually do that manually. Sorry, this is taking a while to get back to the action here. Ultima HP, there it is. That's what I'm looking for. And then hit to conjunction. It doesn't matter. I could just junction nothing to it, but just in the interest of taking something that we had before, let's put Kiraga there, I guess. Okay, now he's up to full HP. Right, and now we're gonna give her Pandemona. She doesn't really need anything new. Okay, we are good to move on. Okay, so, oh, I didn't say what Cerberus is. Cerberus is much like Carbuncle in that he is a support summon and that he doesn't attack the enemy. Instead, he gives everybody in the party the triple status without you actually having to consume any of your triple magic, so you can use three magic in one turn just by after summoning Cerberus for a set amount of time, and it's great. So interestingly, even if I did not want auto haste, I could just summon Cerberus and then cast haste three times in one turn to get haste on everybody, but I'm just talking in hypotheticals now, so let's figure out where we're trying to go. Now that our main step has been fixed. So yeah, putting a guardian force, and here's the waiting room where we learn that about Cypher's quote-unquote death. Yeah, the auto-junction system is definitely showing its poorer qualities by trying to junction Ultima of all spells to Squall's hit rating. Okay, we need lock 3 for that elevator. That personally looks to me like a big deal elevator. And that's where I believe if we came up here before we fought Cerberus, we would still be able to see him down there. Just as a sort of like, hey, you really ought to fight this thing because it's really rad. I kind of wish I had checked its draw list, but I'm pretty sure it's just doubled and triple, which obviously we have no need for, although not in that context anyway. I mean, Zell is doing pretty respectable damage without as much triple as Renoa and Squall. And there's double. Let's pick it up, sure. Why not? Just for the fun. This is an auditorium, but I'm not certain that we're supposed to do anything here, yeah. Just kind of an auditorium for show, so Galbadia can flaunt its wealth, I suppose. Where in the world is the door that we came out of? There it is, on the very southernmost bleachers. Okay, so this is not where the third student is. Oh, didn't want to do that. So we should check one of the other wings connected to the area where we fought Cerberus. Let's save one more time now that we have, what was it, 5 doubles to our name and extra. I love that. I'm not sure that you heard that, but I love that even my PS3, so many years later, chugs to read the disc like how my PlayStation 1 used to. That very brief noise, scratching noise, or not scratching because that would be horrible for the disc, but you know what I mean? It's a very chunky machine scanning noise. It's very nostalgic to hear. Not as nostalgic as, say, the PlayStation 1 opening noise intro, but it's up there. Okay, more doors to check. Always fun, always good stuff. Not in here. It's kind of interesting that you can't go to the other side of the classroom, although I suppose that maybe there is a wall there, but even then it might be too confusing if you could transfer over multiple layers. Here's the last card key. It'll open the lock on the elevator. The sorceress's room is on the top floor. Good luck, guys. And there we go. Dungeon complete. Ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba. Where does this let us out to? Bottom floor. suppose makes sense, because we did take a staircase down. Right, let's not waste any time. We have Cerberus, so we're not supposed to go in there. We have Cerberus, so we have nothing extra to do in here. So let's just head straight for the Sorceress's room and see what's going on, and hopefully put a stop to this sudden war. We'll save down here. Draw point again. I forgot about that. I was about to comment on the fact that that's weird. There's an invisible wall here. I think I might have even said that the first time we were in the lobby for Galbadia Garden, but. I'm gonna go ahead and guess the elevator to the Sorceress's room is the scary thorn door. I wonder if she had this put in especially, because it doesn't seem very in line with the design and aesthetic of the arena, or the school itself so far. Garden, that's what it's called. Just going to very slyly not go too far forward so we can save before we talk to Cypher and Edea. You guys shouldn't have. I was gonna come visit you in my old home. Shut up. Did you guys come to fight Matron after all that she's done for us? Renoa, what are you doing here? You're gonna fight me too. Come on. Remember a year ago we... Stop it. Hey, chicken wuss. Lots happened between us, eh? Yeah, I'm dying to get even. It's too late, Cypher. You can't mess with our minds. To us, you're just another enemy, like one of those monsters. You're comparing me to one of them. Boisterous laughter. I ain't no monster. I'm the Sorceress's knight. And look at you, attacking like a swarm. You guys are the monsters. If our previous fights with Cypher are any indication, this will be no challenge at all, so I'm just going to... He has haste, dispel, thunder, and fire. I don't care enough. Let's just attack him. Is that all you got? I can't be beaten. Well, I got some bad news for you, I think. Some very imminent bad news. It's also a high potion, really. It's also kind of humorous that Cypher never gets crits, it would seem. He's very bad at pulling the trigger. This can't be. Why? Eight mega potions, that's helpful enough. Oh, Quetzalcoatl, I forgot to teach you something good. If we learned elemental defense times two, though. Okay, definitely gonna have to make, if we learn higher strength, strength plus 60%, or whatever it was, next tier. Worthless child. Also, I do like how the orphanage scene twist gives Cypher more of a reason for joining up with the Sorceress, at least in my opinion. The auditorium is right below, and that is where we just were, so let's head back there. There's no way you guys can beat her. I love the subtle movement of the chandelier there, if that is what that is. I also really enjoy that when she sits on that seat, whatever that is she's sitting on, there's just sort of wispy drapes of white. The environmental designers of this game really knocked it out of the park. Just leave Cypher there to his own devices. Shouldn't be too long to get to the auditorium. If I remember where it is, it's up. That's right. What's interesting is that going around this room, the auditorium doesn't seem like it would be right below where Edia went down, which I felt like was on the other side of, you know, the other side of this valley, so I'm not sure what the deal with that is. Because we didn't really travel the same distance horizontally, but whatever, it doesn't matter. Very scary music. What's going on? So the time has come. You're the legendary seed destined to face me. What is she talking about? I must say that I am impressed. An impressive nuisance. Your life ends here, seed. Worthless fool. You're not our matron. All seeds must perish. Round two is Cypher, it would seem. We can't target. Cannot target EDA just yet. So let's see how many turns this takes from Squall. I'm gonna guess one after the added damage of Renoa. Nice job, Renoa. Total of 3,000 damage right there. Oh no, he probably has 4,000 or 5,000 or something. Probably around. Oh, that was pretty close. Uka. Damn, I'm disgraced. Oh no. Okay, I absolutely was not expecting that, so hopefully I don't do too much damage. Okay, I didn't want to guarantee a crit. Because we defeated useless fool. Enough play, seeds must die. I thought she was saying that she was defeated for a second, and I was terrified. You can probably guess why. There's Maelstrom, definitely looks like a, gravity ability that does percentage-based damage, and there's Alexander, our next Guardian Force, another Final Fantasy classic. I think this fight's over. Yep. I forgot to change. Oh, I forgot to change what the Guardian Forces were learning. Okay, Holy War is a fantastic item, as you can tell. I'm definitely gonna save those. If I ever use them, it'll probably be way, way later, the end of the game or something. Force Armlet. Oh, look at all this worthless learning. Oh, Leviathan learned Recover, though. That's great. And Tombray learned Familiar. Fantastic. Some good news to back end that. I really need to show off some summons here soon. We've gotten 3 or 4 now with Alexander that I haven't shown the animations for. I guess it would be 4 including Odin, but I can't guarantee. I can't show off Odin whenever I want. What happened? My Noah. Cipher. Zell, you've all grown so much and become so strong. I have waited for this day to come and also feared this day would come. Is today a joyous day or an odious day? Where is Alone? Have I protected Alone? I don't understand. Squall. It's Rinoa. If that isn't the biggest freaking cliffhanger for a disc swap, and to be fair, Disc 1 gave it a run for its money as well, but we don't know the well-being of Rinoa this time instead of Squall, so I'm gonna do that really quick. Appreciate the screen for a moment, and then I will see you in a second. Is it over? What happened? Rinoa. What happened to Rinoa? Squall, can you hear me? Head to Edia's house at once. The sorceress Edia, matron, is back at the orphanage. Definitely starting off with some interesting, which what promises to be at least some interesting development. And so we shall head up to the bridge. Nice to see we didn't lose a seed level doing anything at the end of Disc 2. And yeah, now we are officially on Disc 3. Disc 2 just flew by, in my opinion. Oh, interesting, we can go to the basement floor. I'm quite pleased that I did not waste a whole video finding chocobo treasures in the forest. Especially because, obviously, as judging by how quickly we just went through the main story and boss fights and whatnot, we did not need the help. Given that very casual NPC dialogue we just had, it would appear that the worst of the events are behind us, for the time being, at least. Matron is back at that house. What does Zoo have to say? Where's our next destination? Well, that house, of course. Before we head into the house, though, cannot take Rinoa because she's out of commission, so let's take Questus. There we go. Really wish it was easier to heal up in this game. I would have to walk all the way back to the dormitory. Can we see any ruins of Galbadia Garden? would seem not. So before we head inside, let's take a look at the new summon we got. And also, make sure we're learning good things. Elemental defense times 2. And then, elemental defense junction. And strength. Oh, I thought we had strength plus 60% to learn. That's too bad. That would have been great to have on Squall, if so much. I guess let's learn boost. I mean, that's only 10 points. It's not going to last us very long. And I'm going to forget to change it again. Strength bonus. Magic plus 40%. Brothers can do HP plus 80%. That's insane. Let's learn these. The elemental attack and defense junctions. Diablo's still learning Monk. Just really close. Probably the next boss battle. No matter how intense of a fight it is, at least 20 AP will learn in Mug, which is good for getting items. Status defense junction, sure. Leviathan can learn. Spirit plus 20%, that's fine. Pandemona still working on speed. Cerberus still working on speed as well. Alexander, okay, here we go. Alexander can teach the command revive, which is really great to pair with recovery, obviously, because recovery revives, recovery heals someone to full HP, and then revive can obviously, so you do revive first, then you heal to full HP. It's not, doesn't require that much explaining, I suppose. Okay, so in order to get auto haste, what we need to do is we need to learn medicine data first, and then that unlocks, I think, Med Refine, or maybe High Magic Refine. I'll have to look that up between this video and the next one. So yeah, I'm gonna, and Elemental Defense times 4 is crazy. The fact that you can junction 4 different magic to Elemental Defense, but we're gonna learn to focus on Med Data right now. You know, who to put Alexander on. Well, I'll worry about that later. I'm pretty sure we are going to have cutscenes that are more dialogue heavy to the end of the video before I have to worry about any combat, so. True to my word, I'm now saving on the first slot of disk of my virtual memory card instead of the second one. And disk four, I will go back down to the second one. I'll go after you, Squall. Okay, okay. There's so much we want to ask the matron. Nice to be here physically instead of in a memory or a dream or whatever that was. Shared consciousness experience. There he is. It's been a while. Many thanks for your hard work. Ha ha ha. Are you angry with me? I don't blame you. All I do is talk big, but in times of trouble, I run away. I was in a no-win situation. Your defeat could be the end of you. Your victory would mean losing my wife. I just couldn't bear to face either outcome. I don't care about myself, but please forgive Edea. Who is presumably right across this transition. There she is. My children, please forgive me. I raised you as my own, yet still I. We feel the same way. We fought you too, knowing you were our matron. Matron, you are seeds. You cannot back out of a battle, I know. You were magnificent. However, it is not over yet. At any time, I may. I have been possessed all this time. I was at the mercy of sorceress Ultimisia. Ultimisia is a sorceress from the future, a sorceress many generations ahead of our time. Ultimisia Alicia's objective is to find Alone. She is after Alone's mysterious power. I knew Alone very well. Ultimisia is a very fearful sorceress. Her heart is filled with anger and hate. There was no way I was going to let Ultimisia get a hold of Alone. The only thing I could do was surrender my soul to Ultimisia and lose control of my mind. That was the only way I could save Alone. And the end result, well, you all know. The sorceress that appeared in Galbadia was in fact Ultimisia inside my shell. Ultimisia has yet to achieve her goal. I believe she may use my body again to carry out her plans. I plan to make a stand this time, but if that does not work, I may have to face you in battle once again. I ask for your support, young seeds. Have you all heard of Sorceress Adele before? She was the ruler of Estar during the Sorceress War. No one knows of her whereabouts. That's what I learned. The Galbadians must have thought I was the sorceress who received Sorceress Adele's powers. However, that is not the case. I received the powers of the previous sorceress at the age of 5. Which means, I believe Sorceress Adele is still alive, and that Ultimisia released my body in order to use the body of Sorceress Adele. Sorceress Adele is the type who will not hesitate to use her powers for her own selfish desires. Should Sorceress Ultimisia from the future bequeath her anger and hatred unto Adele, their power would be unimaginable. Sorceress Adele is the, okay. So yeah. Final Fantasy sometimes in certain games has the tendency to lead you to believe that an antagonist is the antagonist and will be the ultimate enemy of the game, then suddenly switcheroo on you and realize that there's actually a greater enemy working behind the scenes, and Ultimisia is that antagonist. And it turns out that Adia, the matron to all of the orphans at this orphanage, was being manipulated, or rather outright controlled, dialogue and everything, by a sorceress from the future called Ultimisia in order to find the previous sorceress from the Sorceress War that we've heard about quite a few times now, and also from Laguna. Laguna was fighting in the Sorceress War, because now that we know that he was in the past, she's trying to find Sorceress Adele in order to take her body so that they can combine their powers and do horrible things because they're villains. Please listen to what Edie has to say. Who knows when she may be possessed again. Probably try to... Okay. Squall, I'm sure Matron has much more to say. I've heard enough. I understand that listening to what Matron has to say is important, but Renoa... Matron, do you know what's wrong with Renoa? Renoa is the girl in light blue. I remember vaguely what happened to her. She was with us when we fought you after the battle. Her body was cold. She didn't move. Did Renoa die? No. Forgive me, Squall. I don't think I can be of any help. It's all right. Squall, I understand how you feel, but you are in a position of leadership. The other students at Garden have a right to know about the outcome of the battle and what's to come. Take whatever information you can get here back to Garden. Remember, it wasn't just Renoa. Everyone fought. I understand, but that isn't something a leader should say. Damn it. Ultimisia's objective is to find Alone. First time we met was the day I became a seed. We met again, in Timber. Alone's mysterious power, sending one's consciousness back into the past. We had a lot of arguments at first, but in time, things began to change. So Ultimisia wants to use Alone's power, right? I get it. Ultimisia wants to send her consciousness from this period further into the past. You were looking at me. You smiled when our eyes met. What's she going to do in the past? Time compression. depression. It made me feel calm, tranquil. It's time magic, past, present, and future get compressed. What's going to happen to the world? Why do something like that? Renoa, give me another chance. I can't even imagine a world where time is compressed. Yo, Squall. You're not even listening. So basically, all we have to do is prevent Ultimisia from getting a hold of Alone. Yes, but we're going back to Garden. We have to let everyone know. Hey, we're worried about Renoa too, you know? Then why don't you forget it? The update. Our task at hand is to find Alone, then we'll deal with Ultimisia. I believe that Alone is on the White Seed ship. We're setting out to look for it. I wonder where it could be. We'll gather information for a while. Be prepared for battle at any time. And Sorceress Edia is back at her home. She's probably not our enemy anymore. Let's just leave her alone. But not alone. Is Renoa in the infirmary? I'll go visit her later. I don't want to say this in front of Quistis and you, but I don't know if some people will be so forgiving. It's a good point. If I'm just going to get into the control of the airship, land, and then save, and then say goodbye. Now that we are on Disc 3, crazy how fast we're moving. It's still just as fun as the first video when I recorded. For me, at least. Okie dokie, time to go to save. And now we can see, oh well, it's already Disc 3, but now we can see an updated version of where it says Disc 3. We're on the Centra continent at the Cape of Good Hope. And I'm going to wish you a good morning, day, evening, or night. And I will see you at the next part.